Hooray for Hollywood. What is Sundance? It's a promotion festival for new and exciting entries into the wonderful world of cinema. I went to the Sundance Film Festival to promote The Filth and Fury, a documentary, a true documentary on the Sex Pistols.
Killed Bambi with Russ Meyer.
Oh, it's you!
How are you?
You said you have to buy me 2 6-packs of Guinness and a can of baked beans, or I'm not getting out of this car. Can I get a picture of you?
Yeah.
Well, that's great. We're gonna get that.
Happy to bring the film to Sundance?
I don't know yet. Hello, my name's John. Welcome to my life. I love this film. We worked hard on it. It's the serious, real deal. Just for once, getting it not fake.
I am an anti-coast. I am an anarchist.
Don't accept the old order. Get rid of it.
How old were you at that time? You in your early 20s or so? Was it?
No, it's 18. Oh, 17, 18.
You were that young.
It's a true film. There's no bull in it. There's no lies. There's no dishonesty. It is what it is. It's a story about people hating each other.
I'm bored with all this bollocks.
You and Steve are mates then, or do you? Is it more?
Look,
like
we get on. Yeah, we get on really well with each other, and then not.
Make us look sophisticated. Oh, damn it. You got this? You seen it?
No.
It's the trouble when you don't wear underwear.
How do you explain the legacy of the Sex Pistols, the fact that they were able to make such an impact over a short period of time?
Lack of shoelaces.
God save the Queen! The fascist regime!
What do you think of The Filth and the Fury?
I think it's a dreadful film, and everyone in it should be shot in the morning. Absolutely awful. You know, Hangman's Noose is the first thing that comes to my mind when I see that dreadful John Rotten. He's someone I wouldn't recommend to anybody at all. He's so arrogant, he's so conceited, he's so full of himself. Well, you know, now I come to think of it.
I'm here with Johnny Rotten of In the Filth and the Fury. Johnny, tell me about the film, please.
It stars Johnny Rotten and Steve Jones, who's immediately to my right. So, you silly cow, you're f***ed up already, ain't you? Go take a detour. Go on, go away.
Are you serious?
Yeah, why not? Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
You're a bit odd, aren't you?
Odd? What do you mean? Would you like me to hit you with your microphone?
No.
If you could sum up your days in the Sex Pistols in 5 words or less, what would you say?
2. It's over.
See, 1, take 6.
Actors and actresses have to be really professional salesmen to promote their fodder. The same applies for me.
Virgin Suicides. I'm promoting my film.
I'm here promoting a movie called Love and Sex.
I've got Scream 3 coming out.
It's about the V-Poets.
It's kind of lowly based.
You're playing a character.
It's an homage.
Well, hilariously, I'm here promoting a Filth and Fury, the Sex Pistols, the truth and the whole truth, nothing but.
Well, what is it?
But we have no merchandise except these silly little buttons.
This is the cheesiest, this is the most worthless cheesy merchandising in the history of the earth, okay? This is like a butt plug. So cheesy. So beyond cheesy, okay? I'm so glad. I mean, if you had like really genuine merchandising, it would have been the end, you know? Oh, the Sex Pistols still live because they believe in the cheesiest merchandising of all time.
Take some au naturel so I'm not posing.
All right, thank you.
Hello, hello.
This is a good face.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
And then...
Oh, no, you're what? Dribbling from your schnozzle. I just seen it. Oh, Mrs.
It's the Johnny Rotten Show. Doobie-doobie-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. Doobie-doobie-doo-doo. Rotten.
And here comes beautiful young Hollywood.
Interviewer.
Oh, I would say yeah. So. Tell me, are you doing lots of this press blurb stuff, and does it get on your tits?
This is the most unique, I think, one we've done so
far. It's all over my tits.
Now, you got a film called Committed.
Yeah. We like it. So when Casey first saw it, he didn't think he was good in it. He's very, like... Or maybe you were just fishing for compliments.
I was.
What are you doing here?
Well, I think it's kind of got a vibe of a little bit of, like, a Coen Brothers film. I don't know. Maybe you don't think so?
No, it is nice to meet you. You've done some seriously great films.
Oh, thanks, man.
Is that it? Bye.
But I have a dumb question. Did you like the movie Sid and Nancy?
No, I hated
it.
No, it was appalling.
Really?
It was a load of old nonsense.
Why?
It celebrated drugs, and I won't tolerate that nonsense at all.
So do you get nervous when you're playing in front of an audience?
You're dead terrified.
That seems scarier, because like a movie, you're just...
Yeah, absolute vomit buckets all over the place. Total panic, can't eat all day.
Wait, you ever walk off the stage?
No. No. I've been bottled off stage. That's a different kind of a thing, isn't it?
You're lying.
No, I'm not.
They threw bottles at you?
Don't you know anything about me?
Do you guys want to hear a funny concert story?
Yes.
You may not think it's funny, but... Okay, a friend of mine is working a documentary about Kid Rock, and he went to one of his concerts, and the drummer or the guitar player came up to him, and he said something in his ear, and he's like, oh, my God, I'm going to tell everyone. And the guitar player's like, no, don't tell everyone. And he goes, okay, this guy has to take a shit, and you should go ahead and do it. And so the guy he's like, no. He's like, go, take it. And so they sat there for 20 minutes and waited for the guy in the middle of the concert.
You should do it on stage. I've had diarrhea in Brazil. I've had to do it on the bucket while howling.
See, that's a lie. No, you're telling the lie.
Afraid not. I've got it on film.
Don't they spit on you or something like that? Like, if they like you?
No.
It's like you say they like you.
No. You spit on me and it's like a declaration of warfare. All right, well, that'll do. Peace and love made a road rise.
Thanks, Bartman.
I smell a lemon. Review. Bad. Review. Good. Me. Yeah, they threw a party for the Sex Pistols. Look, there's more people leaving than arriving.
So are you now.
Excuse me, hold on a minute,
Shut. Right. And guess what? They wouldn't let me in.
Go on
I'll end
way.
Up in jail.
Go on way.
My party,
if you don't
I'll end up
this restaurant,
in jail.
Go on your
it's
way.
Okay.
Go on
No,
your
it
way.
Isn't. Yeah. I'll go on your way. Hello, Nora. How are you? This is Mr. and Mrs. Rotten here. Aren't we a lovely pair?
Oh, I don't like the flow shots. You know. Go away.
We should have some more of these stiff conversations for the camera. Oh, farting like an idiot. Nora, where are you going?
This is Mrs. Rotten.
Mrs. Rotten?
See, that's one of the many things people don't know about me. I'm loyal.
The wife wants it louder. What can you do?
Important questions of the moment. Is there a future for Hollywood?
This Gen Y coming up, as they call them. I mean, I'm looking at these people at Sundance. I mean, there's thousands of people here making movies. It doesn't cost them anything now with the technology, so they can make a movie about anything they want to make it about.
Fat chance in this day and age, right?
It has democratized art and taken out of the hands of the Mike Ovitzes of the world and put it back in the hands of the people.
Look, unimportant people with passes.
I mean, it's amazing. These kids can make feature films now for, you know, $1,400 and, you know, get yourself a Canon camera and away you go.
I think you'd dig it. A series of interviews with Stanley Kubrick's younger brother, Maury.
And it's like, you know, people come up, all these young guys come up.
What's your name, man?
Farquhar Farjibottom.
I always want to talk to them because I figure, you know, the biggest mistake you can make when you're established in some way
is to diss the young.
Well, not only diss the young, I mean, they're the wave of the future, you know. And if you want to stay in this business and do the stuff you really enjoy, then they're the people you want to be, you know, a part of.
Shut up, Spotty. Yeah! Spotty!
Woo! Yeah! You know who I am?
My, the younger generation. Good dose of Clearasil, clear the lot of them up. Oh, what fun it can be talking to the stars.
This is actually my first interview, first anything I've been doing here. It's the first time.
Oh, my God. There's Mr. Rotten interview.
Exactly.
You know what? If I take my hat off, I think we're going to look. Yeah, we're going to match.
There you go.
The hat head.
That's Johnny Rotten right there. You show him some damn respect.
Oh, yeah, and more of that.
I mean it.
There's a lot of snobbism I've seen. You know, it's a lot of the young starlets are like pulling poses, but we expect them to do that because they're talentless. I'm looking for Cindy f***ing Lauper. Cindy! Cindy Lauper, where are you? Because boys just want to have fun. Girls just want to have fun.
Well, they have a lot.
You got a lot to answer for.
Me?
I'm pleased to meet someone with more makeup than I have.
Oh, well, what do you expect?
You do your stuff and you don't sell out and cop out.
Well, I hope you feel that way about the new stuff.
I won't. Just to be fashionable. Whenever you run into someone who's just a regular person, you know, who isn't pretentious, that's a marvellous thing.
I've got all these memories of listening to Sex Pistols live in Dublin in 78,
76. Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
You know, I still haven't been allowed to play there.
No,
in Ireland, never. Never,
really?
Not in any band I've been in since. Still banned outright. That's why I dropped any kind of national pride years ago. Just I now get on with life.
Yeah.
The world's my oyster.
Uh-huh.
Irish heart, English sensibility, and the American dream. A true star was here. Now I suppose I should go and talk to some of the fakes.
Hi, I'm Nev Campbell.
I think that will do. Oh, now I can go and get a cup of coffee. Apparently Christopher Walken's walking about. Have you seen him yet?
I have not seen him.
Fire. People have told me he's a bit nutty. Oh, there he is.
Oh,
he looks nutty too. Looney at 2 o'clock.
I don't want to get him pissed off.
Oh, come on, let's do it anyway. Oh, come on. Christopher. I'd like to say hello. He's Superman for you.
Hey, how are you?
Sure. Yeah, we very well, yeah.
Christopher. I'd like to say hello. He's Superman for
me. Well, yes, very, very well.
I don't want to butt in. I know you'd like doing your stuff for now, but apparently we're going to have a chit-chat in a bit. It's up to you.
Good.
We all need to get ready. Makeup! I come not to bury Caesar, but to praise him. The biggest fun of meeting all these wild and crazy, wonderful film personalities is how ugly they all are up close. They're just like the rest of us. Spots, zits, warts and all.
This you have here is not a pimple. This is a very rare condition. I see this one time before in Germany. You have here one penis.
I like this. This interview is so good.
Oh,
it's
damn.
Really good. You're doing a good job. I really like it. What time is it? How long have we been here?
No. Oh, shut your face.
Oh, shit.
can you ever get an honest answer out of someone inside the industry? Are their responses satisfactory? Enter DeVito. Yes, promotion. I mean, that's what the Sundance Festival was all about, and I understood that, and I know that there's an importance, because you have to promote. Obscurity doesn't get you anywhere, and you have to be brave and proud of what you do, so you have to put yourself up on a pedestal.
I think you have to learn and love it.
Is it two careers?
It is, because you really, that's what you get paid for, I think. Get out there and promote your movies. You do 60 one-on-ones, which is like, you have four-minute interviews where people come in and change in the seat, and it's just constantly asking that same question over and over again.
Repetition.
And I can understand everybody wanting to hear that answer and wanting them to be in the room with you.
Yeah, but I wasn't really getting to that.
What are you talking about, John? Clear it up, baby.
Well, you took so long on that last ramble.
Well, you know, it's film. You can cut it out.
Oh, are you filming? Once you're up there in that light, then you're packaged,
mm-hmm.
and you get contained and bracketed, and you cannot break out.
Yeah, it's break out, man.
Let's
break out before we get trapped.
Yeah,
that's the way.
We're always skirt around the outside like a little terrorist.
That's right. Yeah, yeah.
My style.
That's right. You know, you kiss your women, you sip your wine, and every once in a while you throw a grenade.
Yeah. Does it annoy you? Because it does me a bit. But pretty faces get it so damn easy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, please. I mean,
such a
come
piss
on.
Off, isn't
well,
it?
I mean, ever well,
being ugly.
When you were a kid, I mean, like, didn't it, like, you know, you're always forced to, like, work your way into some situation rather than have it laid in your lap?
We were all victims of the spoiled, beautiful people
there
at school.
Go.
So why do people then rush to see those very same bastards on film?
No, it's beyond me.
All right, hold it right there, buddy boy.
Somebody told me, and I haven't seen it, but I want to, and if there is a copy about, I'd love to see it. It's a student film you did when you were a very young man.
Yes.
You were a photographer?
Hot Dogs for Gauguin. Really exciting. It was the first movie that I ever did.
Roger Ebert, what is your estimation of that man? He's this major league reviewer who's terrifying most of the industry. I mean, you know, if he gives a film a diss, it's kind of relatively important.
You know, there is a point in life, I think, when the orange mohawk has to go.
He's always been a big supporter of mine.
Very odd that a man like that could get a job like that.
I'm glad he's out there.
Yeah, he's a sneak attack on the industry.
Yeah.
What did you call it? An attack hamster.
Attack hamster. Good, John. That was good. I'm not a big fan of reviews, and I'm not a fig. I don't learn anything from them. They only make me feel bad.
Yeah.
Do me a favor. You read all my reviews. I won't read any. Any ones you want to send me, send them over.
There's a good way of sheltering
Isn't
yourself.
Is that the way to do it?
Yeah, and no, because I go around it the other way, that I want to read the bad
you
ones.
You do?
Yeah, because the good ones, I can't take compliment well.
Right. No,
I go all shy.
Yeah, right. And the bad ones, how they make you feel better?
Okay,
make
me realize they're not really reviews,
somebody,
they're personal assaults.
Yes, that's right.
And bitter.
So you like reading that stuff?
Yeah, I do.
Oh, good. Okay, John. Are you a big advocate of guns?
No, I'm not. No. The less people that have guns out there, the better it is for the likes of me and my big mouth.
Yeah.
You know, it's too easy to get shot in this.
Boy, it is terrible, yeah.
And that kind of mania is spreading around the world. And I blame Arnold Schwarzenegger.
You do?
Trying to link you back to films.
No, please don't, John. I was a fan, but from afar. Okay? I really was a fan. I really enjoyed, you know, seeing it, all the turmoil and all
You know, forgive me, but I laugh at that because I can't take compliments.
No, you shouldn't. But I didn't say I was a fan of yours.
All right. Peace.
Okay, it was nice talking with you.
Peace off.
Peace.
Denny!
John!
Yeah?
Come with me.
You guys don't have to come.
No,
you don't have to come. You guys stay here. Okay, we'll be back. Here we are, off the cuff with Johnny Rotten. Okay, let's see now. Let's see. Just improvise any questions you'd like to ask, John.
Okay, is it true your name's Danny?
Yeah, yes, it is, John. Very good question. So astute, so deep and searching.
Oh, I've got one here.
What do you got there, John?
The Tennessean recently put an article out about you and called it Living DeVito Loca.
Check, please.
Scene one, take three.
Parting is such sweet sorrow.
Oh, there's one last thing, right? Biggest fun of the lot. Is as I'm going in, someone shouted out, is that Billy Idol? Success.
I really didn't mean to hurt anybody. You all just misunderstood where I was coming from.